He will also be not alone with Jens. Yeah, hello, Jens. How are you?
Hi, I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing well, doing well. Waiting also for Ivan to. So you will co-present. I don't know with in which order you wanna go.
Yeah, I can present. In any case, I need Ivan as well for the presentation. So.
Yeah, Ivan is joining. Also, he's coming. He's walking digitally on the back from the backstage to the main stage.
Yeah.
Digital walk. Yeah, are you able to share a screen?
Yeah.
Yeah, perfect. The APIfication or appification, I don't know, of insurance. Yeah, from Balois Insurance. Thank you, Jens. So Ivan will join. But you can start. Hi, Ivan.
He's joining now.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Hi. You can start, Ivan.
Okay. Yeah. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for the opportunity to present at this afternoon's conference. I'm Ivan. I'm from Balois Insurance. We're an insurer in Belgium, and my colleague together, Jens and I, will give you a little bit of an insight about, you know, what our vision is in the API space and how we see not only the future, but give a little bit of an insight into what we're doing today, because I think that's always interesting. So, Balois is a traditional insurer in a very highly competitive market, and the expression always goes that insurance is never really bought; insurance is always sold. And what do we mean by that? You know, like. Insurance is something that isn't always front of mind when people consume other products and services. And the API space really helps us as an organization embed our products into the user and customer experience. So the number one priority for Balois at the moment is digital transformation. So we're giving a lot of investment and energy in that space. And the digital transformation investment is really to enhance the customer experience. And I believe that when you focus on the customer experience, you can then supply your products in an added value sort of way. So, you know, I guess the aspirational statement or the vision here is to imagine a world where you didn't have to sell your insurance. Imagine being in a world where it sort of sold itself and it was seen as a valuable service that people actually want. And, you know, we've probably experienced some of that in our day-to-day lives as this industry starts to evolve. I'm sure many of us have seen the concept of extended warranty at checkout when we buy an electronics product, or perhaps we do customize specific insurance products like high-risk travel activity and so on. We believe that embedding ourselves in the customer experience through the digital transformation process is definitely the way of the future. So, you know, in Belgium, we have a few examples that we'd like to share with you on how we're already trying to go down that road. So when you look at an image like this, this is invokes a whole bunch of different emotions. You could probably think passion, you could probably think speed, you can think adventure, exploration. But I'm pretty sure that nobody in our audience looks at an image like this and says, I better check my insurance policy and when it expires. you know, that's the sort of space that we want to try and get into. And if we look at the following image, you know, you'd think to yourself, well, does this remind me about my insurance policy either? I'm not sure. Maybe Jens, you can help us out.
Yeah, exactly. So everyone knows when you buy a car, you actually need an insurance because, well, it is compulsory in most or all countries. So as a car dealership, it's almost a logical step to go beyond selling even cars and to go towards that compulsory step of insurance. So basically, Volvo is an example where the dealership organization, together with Balois, actually created a cross-industry cooperation. And what they actually do is when you buy a car or whether or not it's new or used, you actually instantly can get an offering for your insurance as well. And it's not even a standard offering or anything. It's really a personalized branded approach. So it is actually a Volvo car insurance. So really what we're trying to do is that optimal and efficient customer experience. And well, that branded approach, that customer-centric branded approach really sets that personalized experience that customers also expect. So not only that, what we're currently going to do is also integrate that insurance approach into the actual car. So new cars always have apps, they have infotainments in impossible ways. They're even more powerful than iPads or whatever these days. So what we can do is integrate all of that insurance data into the car itself and in mobile apps. And you can think what that could become. You can gather that insurance data and documents instantly on your car itself or in your app. And even real-time claims information, real-time claims integration, all of that is possible due to cooperations like this.
Yeah, and at Bawaz, honestly believe that the future of insurance is really focused on the individual customer experience. We think that the future of policies will also be extremely specific as our ability to process data improves. Then the assessment of risk can also improve. And we believe that, you know, there'll be not only specific policies, but micro policies across every single industry. We're giving the example of how we're adding value to the car purchasing experience, but we genuinely believe that that will be the future of how insurance is sold as a value add-on to an existing service purchase or experience. But you know, that's one example of how do we add value to an existing customer experience. But there's also, you know, the elephant in the room question: what about newcomers? What about disruptors? What about startup organizations? You know, how does a traditional insurance organization deal with that level of competition?
Yeah, and that's actually a good question, because our next example is exactly that. So it's a disruptor in Belgium. It's really a disruptor in the mobility market. So Mobly is another example of a partnership that we're doing. Mobly really is gathering a sort of platform that meets the requirements of end customers in a full mobility approach. So let's say they really focus on an end customer peace of mind service. And that's what they do. They really provide mobility as a service. So Mobly actually started up as a car advice company. So they gave advice about which car to buy, what is the total cost of ownership, and including what is the insurance cost of a certain car. So that's where Bawaz came into the picture. We really provided detailed simulations based on, for example, secondhand car sales websites, etc. So instantly when you're going to buy a car, you see the whole cost and the whole simulation of that insurance included in it. And then it actually started to evolve. So they expanded to actually selling those insurances. Of course, API integrated with Bawaz. And they're selling the kilometer-based insurance with actually a car integration. So they integrate that insurance, that kilometer-based aspect, into the car. They install dongles, or they install integration with the car app itself, or with the car in the car APIs itself. So currently, they are really becoming more and more digital, integrating all sorts of partners. So their approach also goes far beyond only insurance. But this is what a real disruptor is doing. They're combining every aspect, every industry across the Belgian market. And they're really trying to get a full mobility approach platform for any end customer that is interested. So on the next slide, you actually see what they're doing. They're creating an app that really does the full platform approach. So basically, navigation is included, the costs of buying a car, insurance, the whole repairs that you need, garages, whatever, everything is included. But not only that, mobility goes far beyond only a car. So they also include, for example, public transport, or even bikes, or steps, or whatever transport that you're trying to use. And it's an actual, I said it a lot of times before, a full mobility approach. And Bauwaze, in this case, provides all things related to insurance, of course. So currently, they're really at a new business approach. So all new contracts are created directly over APIs. Now, we are expanding. They are implementing currently to go to a full contract and endorsement management approach. So they will actually manage the full aspect of insurance on Mobly side as well. Now, this, of course, relies on the strategy of not only the approach of having a partnership, but they really rely on the strategy not to compete with disruptors. This, for us as a Bauwaze point of view, is a necessary partnership that we really want to approach with, and that's relying on the strategy not competing with disruptors, but really enabling a platform for them to be this disrupting thing in the market and actually change something in the market. This is the way to go to a real-time, personalized, multi and cross-channel approach, and with actually that customized experience that people are actually expecting these days.
So we've given just a couple of examples of what we're doing with real partners, one disruptor startup type example, and one a more traditional value add partnership type arrangement. But the APIification of insurance is a Bauwaze strategy from the group. And we're happy to say that in the Belgium market, we're actually one of the leaders, leading branches within the group. Bauwaze Belgium is in the top five insurers in Belgium. And we're proud to say that our focus really is on this partner channel, brokers and partners using our API platform through one channel or another. We also really quite proud to say that we can basically say that we almost sell all of our policies through one of these partnership channels using our API platform. We don't have a direct retail model. Everything that we do is through one type of partnership or another. It's powered by a API platform in Belgium where we have an array of multiple combination of open and specific partner APIs. We focus on new business, non-life, retail products, life products. But we don't just focus on car and transportation that we've been talking about today. We have specific partnerships beyond Volvo in the sort of the luxury car sector, like Jaguar, Land Rover, Lexus, etc. We also have partners with Hyundai, Isuzu, Suzuki. Like I already said, focus extremely heavily on our broker network with our open broker and We Group systems that operate as our middle broker level. We can create ad hoc and multiple marketing and lead generation type systems through our API platform where we have either permanent or temporary forms of hybrid media out there that generate lead and sales for us, again, using our API platform. We're in the real estate business where other startups, an example in Belgium, Rentio, are trying to very similarly, like the Volvo example, put a real estate renting customer together with insurance and package the experience, and we're working with partners like that. And we've given already the examples of how we deal with various different types of startups and disruptors. And like I said, altogether, we're quite proud to say that basically all of Baloise Belgium's insurance policy sales are driven through one channel or another, which is quite an exciting claim, but that's not to say that our journey's over. Digitalization of and the apification of Baloise insurance is probably our single biggest priority at the moment. But you know, the question is, how does this stuff actually work? You know, and I'll hand back to Jens then to look under the bonnet a little bit.
Yeah, exactly. So what we're seeing here is that basically we're having an open API ecosystem. So we provide APIs, we provide not only technical APIs, but we provide business processes, and we enable other partners to actually implement them and to maybe disrupt the market, maybe include them in some other type of branch. And it doesn't really matter what branch. So whether or not it's the health insurance thing, whether or not it's some car dealership or some financial stuff or end customers, whether or not it's in the cloud, real time, it doesn't matter. It's an open API ecosystem, and it's a really generic approach. Now, why are we doing this? Basically, everyone knows insurance companies don't really have the time, nor the money, nor the people, or the time to market capabilities that these startups and disruptors do have. So why try to do all of that multi and cross-channel experience? Why do all that personalization? Why do all that yourself? While other people might have already done it, might have done it better than you, might have done it worse, but okay. And that whole approach really supports that open API ecosystem. That personalized approach really is only possible in a really fast manner if you go into these partnerships. Now, insurance as a service really for that purpose needs to move from a product approach to an actual service-based partnership. We provide services, we provide that whole business process enablement, and that really is the goal. And API-driven partnerships, well, the main thing or the biggest thing now there is really that personalized and branded experience, because customers, you know, in the market really are starting to expect that. Now, that's not only the reason behind that, because that's of course the visible thing towards customers. But the other thing is, insurers in this case are enabled to focus on their core market. Our core market really is data management, really is business process enablement. Get that all figured out, do optimizations on that level, and we just provide those business processes in an optimal way and don't need to worry about actually getting it into the market, because that's what the partnerships are doing. That's what the brokers and the car dealerships and the whatever disruptors and startups, that's actually really gaining that full market approach without actually investing in it yourself. So that's actually what we're really trying to do at Baloise. And let's be honest, it is already going a far way on our end. We have about, 25 partnerships currently ongoing. There are two already in development for the next one. So that's basically the status at our end. So I think it's time for the questions.
Yes, it is. It's time for the questions. So we have a few questions. So we have only 2 minutes, but it's okay. There is a question from Corinna. Is there a financial benefits for the car dealer, Volvo in this case, or any other business when offering insurance services aside from competitive advantage and customer loyalty acquisition?
Yeah, I mean, I think the answer there is...
Yes, of course.
Oh, sorry, Jens. Please, go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay, so yes, of course, there is a financial benefit for the car dealership. So the car dealership in this case really acts as the broker, currently for new business, in the future for the full contract management. So now there really is a new business focused financial advantage to the car dealerships, which really is a one-time benefit let's say. But currently, it's moving on towards a real broker partnership. So the car dealerships really are acting like any other broker in the market.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. How did the API mindset came into Balwa's group? Was it like a bottom-up approach from few managers who said, yeah, I think API are something, we should dive into it and convince top management? Or was it more top management understanding the challenges and delivering it through a top-bottom approach?
Yeah, I think it's a combination of both. In the Belgium market, the broker network is not particularly new as an insurance delivery model, and I think it's a sweet spot of reacting to market needs and market desires, helping our partners, our brokers, to add to their competitive advantage, and then obviously us as an organization seeing that opportunity. You know, we really operate in the spirit of partnership because we believe that helping a broker obviously helps us. And so, to answer your question, digital transformation and the APIification of insurance is a top level sponsored strategy from our group organization, but at the same time, it's an evolving logical progression in the way that we work together with our partners.
Yeah, and I do want to add to that, like a couple of years ago, there was this tipping point of do we still do that broker-centric approach? Do we still do that partnership approach and not an end customer approach directly from Balwaza? And at that point in time, APIs were becoming much more important. And that was just the next logical step. So I think it was a partnership between our business and top level and our IT department. And that really all came together in that tipping point, I think.
Yeah, there is also, as Florian, the insurer tech VC said earlier, there are three channels like direct, going through agents or going through brokers. Does Balwa's group has a strong agent network? And if yes, how do they consume APIs so far?
Yes, we have a very strong agent approach. We really feel that still is a very big benefit for end customers because they still need that personalized approach, which I talked about a lot. And there are a lot of brokers which are already through some way or another using our API. So as Ivan said earlier, we have a couple of partners that really create that middle layer. So they actually create a certain application through our APIs, and they have a couple of brokers that just buy into that or work together with them. And they really have a digital platform. Now, of course, we offer a Balwaza platform for the agents as well. But there are a couple of very big agents that already develop their own front-end applications. And basically, they're consuming our APIs directly. So currently, we're really focused on agents, but that doesn't really mean that we're not focused on the API-driven approach.
I mean, but every time we deploy a new functionality through our APIs, we're actually raising the competitive advantage of our individual brokers. And I think we have every motivation to help them. As an example, last year, we empowered our broker network to be able to process claims in real time to certain levels through the power of our back-end systems. And can you imagine the advantage that is from a customer experience when you contact your broker? We were really proud to say that the money is in the bank before the person comes home. You know, like that only comes through the power of integrated services.
Actually, a great insurer is an insurer that makes their brokers successful. So I agree. I agree with you on this. It seems you are part of the Open Insurance Initiative, right? At least you are part of the community on their community website. Did you design your APIs, let's say, based on really product management requirements or customer-driven, approach? Or did you collaborate with other, let's say, industry partners to design these?
Well, First of all, we definitely didn't design all of these APIs and all of these business processes to a certain specific partner or a partnership or agent or whatever. We really designed, and that's, I think, the only optimal approach to have generic business processes that can be used by anyone. We can, of course, tune them a bit in the background because we do have some agent-specific business logic or whatever. But of course, we have one generic approach. We also have an API portal, which is accessible to all of our partners, and they all use the same APIs. So that really is our generic approach, and that's an important thing for us because that's the most simplistic way to enable as much business process possibilities as possible.
Yeah, one interface to deliver them all. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Perfect. I think it's 3:10 GMT, right? So it's the time for the break. Thank you very much, Ivan and Jens, for being with us.